Do you ever have a friend? This is for the guys, the straight guys. Do you ever have a straight friend out of nowhere just say, dude, I'd suck a guy's dick for $1 million. You? You're like, I was just driving. I wasn't thinking about it. Well, let me tell you something. A guy that says he would suck another guy's dick for $1 million would do it for less. Talk him down. Negotiate with that man. Offer him 20,000, see what happens. How about 10 grand? How about a bagel and a cup of tea? I don't like when straight guys act like they're gay. That could be, you know, disrespectful. Like, hey, what's up? How you doing? Like, why do you act like that? It's fun to act gay, so then you beat the living shit out of them and light them on fire, because it's fun to act Catholic. I grew up Catholic. They scream at you, Jesus died for your sins. I'm fucking 7. Some guy's already dead because of me. Don't touch your penis, you'll go directly to hell. Let Father Flanagan touch it for you. Come here. Old Father Flanagan won't go to hell. He'll just go to another parish. I'm sorry, did I upset some of you that support child molestation? One time during a blowjob, my girlfriend stuck her pinky in my ass, and I loved it. I fucking loved it, and I was like, I gotta go beat up a gay guy after this. Did you ever accidentally have a fight with a gay person, and you don't know they're gay, and then you're like fucking punching him, he's like, ow! Like, shit, I don't want to get charged with a hate crime, so you kill him? Remember when AIDS first came out, they blamed it on the gay people, remember? And then we found out it was the Jews. I know, we were all embarrassed, weren't we? Come on, I'm just kidding. Of course it wasn't the Jews. If it was the Jews, they wouldn't have given it to anyone. Cheap bastards. They would have kept it for themselves. This is our AIDS, you can't have any. It's our AIDS, we're keeping it for us. You want to rent it? We'll rent it to you. Gay people, where are you? Where are the gays? There's a few of you here, I could tell. Gay people, okay. Got some good news, I got some bad news. Good news is you are not going to hell for being gay. That's the good news. The bad news is you're going to hell for naming your parade after one of the 7 deadly sins, you stupid motherfuckers. Pride is one of the 7 deadly sins. Read the Bible! Joel Osteen did a whole fucking subject on that last week. You should have heard it. Yeah, you guys are fucked, though. Seriously. What's wrong with you fucking idiots? You got away with sucking and fucking and doing whatever you wanted. No consequences for that. You're totally within your rights as a human to do that. You go name a goddamn parade after pride. I can't even help you anymore. But can you do me a favor? Can you tell some of these young gay guys that, like, the fight is kind of over now? Like, seriously, nobody hates you? Really? Yeah, here's a fucking Facebook posting. Nobody hates us. Now go find something else to complain about, you little douchebag. Yeah, they're just annoying little and you know what the problem is? Heterosexual people, white heterosexual people in general, are afraid to speak their mind because, ooh, people are gonna think I'm racist or I'm this or that. You either are a racist or you're fucking not. It's that simple. Usually racist and homophobic people don't get up on a fucking stage with lights in their face and say racist and homophobic things. Yeah, they generally fucking are home plotting how to kill your black gay fucking ass. You understand? So you don't have to worry about me. But people of these groups that complain about being treated so fucking awfully, there's like a little bit of bullshit with them too, you know what I mean? Like, I'm gay. I'm gay and I'm angry. I want to fit in and be treated just like everyone else. Well, everyone else is not wearing pink leotards and fucking up traffic and screaming at passersby. Your behavior is inconsistent with your stated desire to be treated like everybody else. You want to make a fucking difference? Go to Lubbock, Texas, motherfucker. Go take your pride parade and I want you to march through the middle of fucking Oklahoma and start making a difference. Bring a truckload of corn and lubricants and just go to fucking town. And you gotta change that slogan till we're here, we're queer, get used to it. I tripped on a dick walking here tonight. We're used to it. And if you're in the closet, fucking die in the fucking closet, you fucking pussy. You're not a faggot, you're a fucking pussy. Well, I'm afraid. Who gives a fuck? So am I, motherfucker. I wish I was gay. I'd suck every fucking dick in this building. Just to be a role model, to show you. You want to talk about freedom? Well, if you're a gay person and you're in the closet, fuck you. Don't ever talk about freedom until you fucking come out and say, and fuck your parents. Well, my parents won't accept it. Good. Kill the fucking two of them. Kill them. Kill your fucking parents. Or just move out. Move out. Kill your parents or move out. Those are your two choices. I mean, come on, the gay neighborhoods are the most beautiful neighborhoods around. Right? Everywhere you go, it's like, what the fuck? Oh, those fucking queers, I'll tell you, they make a neighborhood really neat. It's unbelievable. They should burn down every fucking drug-infested, fucked-up neighborhood in America, just send a bunch of fucking homos in there with paint and fabric, and rebuild the infrastructure of our nation. I'm sick of the debate. Gay people born gay, they act gay. Either way, who the fuck are you to even ask that question? Who am I to ask that question? Do you realize how insane that is for us to sit around debating whether or not someone's allowed to be who the fuck they are? That's insane. It's fucking crazy. It's fucking bizarre to me. If you spend your time thinking about what other people do in their fucking bedroom or in just in their... Hey, that's another stupid comment, because being gay ain't all about fucking each other. That's part of who they are. Gay people don't molest children. That's another fucking thing. They think, well, the priest, if we let them get married, it's because they're gay. No, they're pedophiles, you dumb fuck. Fucking a kid has nothing to do with being gay. It's like I like to fuck kids. If you're a man and you fuck a young kid under 18, that's, if it's a boy or a girl, it's the same fucking thing. You're fucking pedophile. If a 17-year-old boy fucks a 15-year-old boy, they're just young queers. That's it. No harm, no foul.